All right. Hello, 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 everyone. Let me give the ads a chance to run for a couple seconds, get everybody up in here.
That's why I figured I had time. Fix my coffee.
All right. I got an email saying that I'm live. Like I didn't know.
Maybe it's, you know, because you might not know. Maybe somebody else is going live on your channel.
All righty. So far we have Zen Incense Shop, Bayou Dawn, Mind and Body Co., Stringfield Ridge Farm, Jenny Pennington, A. Taylor, Ben's Over Acres, love it, Kaylin Strain, Michigan Daffodil, Jesus, All the Things Acres, Jackie Little, hello and welcome, Rebecca Davis, Melinda Elliott, good to see everyone, welcome, Jackie,
YouTube is helpful like that.
The picture that I used is one that I came across on Facebook. I thought it was a good fit for tonight's topic. It's not my picture. Here in Southwest Louisiana, the gas prices, they're ranging anywhere between about $3.99 to $4.29 in our area. So
I did see a couple of gas stations in the Lake Charles area that are doing a cash price for $3.79.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. And the card price is right at $4.
Sean and Alaska.
So it seems to me like there's a push around here, at least, to go back to using cash.
Yeah, it really seems so.
A lot of the restaurants and stuff are charging a 4% fee to use a debit card or credit card or any kind of card.
Sean in Alaska, I just want to know your name and where you're from. That's all I want to know. Just kidding. let's see. Shelly at Pine Tree Hill.
Sam's Club member prices are about 40 cents lower than others. I haven't checked the one at Sam's here.
Did I say Christy Betts? I like to try to say hi to everyone. Welcome to the
Steve, you doll.
Little Frenchie in Big Texas. Getting started on homesteading. Bub, you got to stop. All right. So, yeah, things have gotten pretty, pretty crappy pretty quickly. Nationwide here in the U.S. for sure. If you're not from the U.S., I'm curious, how are things going in your country?
Is that Sean in here yet?
No, the other Sean is not in here yet.
Well, several people have emailed asking about Kate. For those of you that don't know, Kate tried to feed her computer coffee, and it didn't go well.
Not on purpose.
No, it wasn't on purpose. But her computer was a fatality.
She said she spilled coffee on the computer and the cat. The cat was upset. The computer didn't make it.
So she is doing well. She's in the process of saving up to get a new computer. So.
She
might be
started.
Watching on her phone, but she can't type very, very well.
Be sure if you come to my area, please reach out. Let us know. It's always fun to meet up with people. Mama Z, good to see you.
Wow. In France, it's about 2.1 euros per liter for basic gas. So about $8 a gallon. I think that's about what Sean posted in Canada.
Crazy. Cam Patton Family Compound. Hello and welcome. Life in the up. Just kidding. I know
Camp
it's life
Patton
in the
is
UP.
Here. for a little while. He's got a city council meeting tonight to attend. So please, by all means,
yeah,
that's important.
Yeah, I kudos to you for getting involved in your local politics. Allison Hallett, Hooga Homestead. Hello and welcome.
We're going to Madisonville, Louisiana. I don't know where that is.
I'm going to look it up real quick.
I think we looked it up the last time. I think it's on the east side.
Oh, yeah. North shore of the lake, of Lake Pontchartrain by Covington.
Oh, yeah.
That's way on the other side. Sorry.
I don't buy gas. I don't have anything to put it in. Well, we buy lots of gas for the vehicles and mowers and tillers.
I shared a funny that I saw on Facebook. It said, dieting tip, fill up your gas tank. You won't have money to buy food.
We'll be below 30 this weekend on the Gulf Coast.
Mama Z is getting snow in the morning.
Yeah. We are supposed to be, I think it's Saturday.
Saturday night, Sunday morning is supposed to, it's our next cold spell. We're praying it's the last one. And then we can start putting plants in the ground and really.
They were showing us at 28, and now it's fluctuating a little higher. So maybe we won't get so cold. I think it's showing 33 now. I don't know. I'm not looking forward to any of it, but I'm really hoping it's done, over with. Yeah, winter is supposed to be over.
Twin Cedar Farms Extra. It's been so long since we've seen you, Twin Cedar Farms. Did I tell you they were coming in?
No, I read it on Facebook.
Okay.
I follow their Facebook.
Nice. Tanya Frisbee, hello and welcome. Yeah, ready for the cold temperatures to go? Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm ready to be planting. My greenhouse is full of little baby plants. So I'm going to have to bring those in again. And we're going to have a jungle in that extra bedroom over there for a little bit. But I'm looking forward to getting those planted in the ground.
So, we kind of took it easy today. We had the windows open. The weather was nice. We put some clothes on the line to take advantage of our solar/wind powered clothes dryer. It was just all around a nice day. We vacuumed out the vehicles. It was just really cool. We took it easy. Amy actually took a nap, which is something that Amy normally does not do.
Well,
took a nap next to an open window.
That's because you've been killing me for the last 2 weeks with projects.
The birds were singing. Mm-hmm. It's just awesome. So I said all that to say this. We had an opportunity to really prepare for tonight's stream. We've been going off the cuff a lot. And I made a list of some talking points for tonight. So you're in for a treat.
Well, what did we do this week?
We put out a video, believe it or not. It's been so long since we actually published a video of our garden beds pre-planting.
Yeah.
Just kind of see what we're working with.
And they're still not quite finished.
We do have some plants still in there from last year, some herbs and stuff.
We got the second chicken tractor moved into place. It's not ready yet, but it's getting there.
We moved a building. A building that started out as I built the kids a it's made of wood. I built them like this little castle fort kind of deal. And it's made of wood, but it's painted to look like blocks, like it's built out of stone. And it used to have a thing on the top, the second level for them to climb up to and play and whatnots. Well, anyway, they
outgrew it.
Well, yeah, that the novelty wore off quickly. So Welcome, El Skippy. I see you there. So we moved it out to when Abby got the goats, we moved it out there and used it as a goat shelter. And then after we let go of the goats, it just kind of sat out there and was neglected, and we didn't know what to do with it for the longest time. And then I don't remember what night it was in particular, but Amy couldn't sleep because she decided she had a bright idea to move the building up by the chicken, the existing chicken enclosure and coop and stuff, and just expand that. And when she told me about that, I was like, you know what? That's a freaking good idea. And we had the time to do it. So we got right on it. And I don't know if you saw, put a short video out on that.
We moved the building and had it almost all the way set up in a day.
We had it. When I built the thing, I built it on skids because I knew it's a small building. It'd be great to be able to move it around as needed. And I installed some big, heavy eye bolts in there. So that infrastructure, I guess you could say, was already in there for us to be able to just latch onto it with a tow strap and pull it around the yard with a truck. So it was really easy to do that because we had done the planning.
And then the next day we fixed all the ruts that you made in the yard.
Yeah. So, so now what was a neglected, don't know what to do with it building, now it's being used. So
yeah. And the chickens,
Mary
love
Ruth,
it.
Mary Beth, CJ, hello and welcome. So,
but that allows us to expand our chicken area quite a bit, and it gives us room for quite a few more chickens. So that's the plan, is to extend the flock and hopefully get them to raise their own
Veronica
babies.
Hart, hello and welcome. Yeah. So I mean, spoiler alert. I forgot what I titled the stream tonight. How to survive crippling inflation. Spoiler alert. It's homesteading and preparedness. But we're going to talk about it tonight. A fishes and loaves life. Boy, it's been a little while. Hello, Carol. Welcome. So I was able, like I said, I had some talking points prepared. And I'll kind of refer to my talking points throughout the night here.
I'm going to plant seeds I got from Ginger Ninja in a seed swap. Oh, cool. What kind of seeds? We need to build a new chicken coop. Yeah. Well, our chicken coop got a little bit tweaked in the last hurricanes. So it's a little off level. It got moved a few inches. And
yes,
we had to kind of shovel it back into place.
The building that we just moved, we got it all nice and level, and then we compared it to the old one. I was like, boy. Because the old one's like got a slight lean to it. But it leans to the right, so that's okay. Miss Lippy, I recommended your channel to somebody here locally.
Yikes.
Just the other day, actually.
Buddy filled up this morning $102, and this is every 5 days. Holy mackerel.
This is going to put a hurting on a lot of people, y'all.
Yeah. Well, already we're going to change some of the things that, you know, we're not going to make just willy-nilly trips to go shopping or, you know, whatever. We're going to try to plan our trips out to where we can get multiple things done all at one time.
Is that helicopter again?
Mm-hmm.
There's been a military chopper flying back and forth all day. All right, so Build Back Better has turned out that it means massive government overreach, medical tyranny, censored and discredited experts, a questionable election, record high gas prices, inflation, an inflation rate that we have not seen in over 40 years, empty grocery store shelves, a fear-mongering, dishonest meeting for World War III because ratings.
Sorry.
And the list goes on.
Hang on. Hey, Sue said the helicopter wants to know why you moved the castle. That's why they're passing over.
Hello, Debbie's home place. Welcome. And so I guess, so in essence, I guess those riding with Biden didn't know that the ride would cost so much.
Yeah.
Tanya Frisbee. No, we were in Southwest Louisiana near Lake Charles.
North Shore preparedness.
There's my buddy. How's the fuel price today, Sean?
North Shore preparedness. Hopefully it's not any higher.
Our friend Sean at North Shore Preparedness is up in Canada, and they do price per liter, but he likes to go ahead and take care of the conversion for us to let us know what the cost is. $7 a gallon.
Abby.
In Canada.
Abby, check your email.
I saw it.
So a few of the things that are in the news, I'm going to inject this stuff throughout the stream tonight. So the Russia-Ukraine stuff is being referred to as the first crisis of the Biden presidency, as if the Taliban rapidly taking over the Afghanistan and ISIS-K blowing up 13 American service members wasn't a crisis. Let's see, where are we at here?
Cheaper in France. Yeah. I heard in Russia, gas is like $1.80 a gallon.
And do you know why? Russia's gas is super cheap because Russia is energy independent, like we were a few years ago.
You guys have any tips on growing foxgloves in flower beds? That's nothing I've ever grown.
No.
But I'm sure there's a few people in here that have, so you may just get your questions answered.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Amazon went up on the membership price.
Hello, by the way, Grammy Karen. Good to see you.
Yeah, that makes sense. That definitely makes sense, Grammy Karen. But isn't it funny how it's like everybody knew that it was going to happen?
You are right, bub. Simply Jan, welcome. Yeah, the prices, the fertilizer prices are through the roof, which is going to, if it hasn't already, it's going to affect all of, it's going to affect the food supply and the food prices.
Foxgloves. Take them off the foxes first. Okay, Lippy said, between Russia and Ukraine, they total 43% of our wheat. Follow the yellow brick road to who's behind it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, ask you guys a question.
One thing I did find, though, online on Facebook, I think you had found it and shared it with me. How to make zucchini flour.
Yeah.
That's one thing. I'm going to try to find that article and possibly share it. It's basically overgrowing your zucchini and slicing it super thin, running it through your dehydrator and making it into a powder. You can use a third of that to replace your recipe. Does that make sense? That's not coming out right.
Replace up to a third of the flour in the recipe.
I knew it didn't sound right. I was trying to make sure it came out accurate.
North Shore says fertilizer went from 200 to 800 a ton in a year.
God. Bonnie shared it on her Facebook page. I knew somebody I knew shared it. Zucchini flour, yes. And see, that's something that we can grow pretty prolifically here. So that might be something that we look into trying this year. You can use pumpkin flour the same way. Good to know.
I love learning. Learning from you guys. So the CDC director, Rochelle Walensky, said in an interview that she found out that the jab was effective when CNN announced it. So that sounds kind of backwards to me. The CDC found out from CNN that the jab was effective. Are they playing a blame game?
Yeah, I'm going to look up the pumpkin flower too. I know it would be a lot of extra work, Michigan Avenue, but at the same time, if we can't get flour, then that would be a way to use it. It can also be used as a thickener. I was reading that. The zucchini flour can be used as a thickener in soups and gravies and things like that. So, I think they said you can make it, make tortillas and stuff with it as well, because it's not a rising bread. So you could use just the zucchini flour for that. Acorn flour.
Isn't acorn flour a process? Don't you have to like get the tannins out of the acorns?
Yep.
So I've never tried that. Bannox. Oh, curly dock seeds. You can make flour from the curly dock seeds.
We better have a lot of seeds because those things are tiny. I'm just looking for something that, you know, a third of the flour mix. Yeah. Yeah, zucchini grows in tons of places. So, I mean, it's an option, especially with the rising prices. You know, if you can grow 60 zucchini, you know, and use it for that, I know it's going to be a little more expensive, a little more time consuming, but there's a lot of things that we do that, you know, it might take time, but it's way cheaper on the pocketbook. And right now we have to pinch pennies because, you know, with the two of them, Abby and Brett, both going back and forth to Lake Charles for work, it's going to hurt with the gas prices. Exactly, Veronica. I've got the feeling when it's all said and done, we will be using our growing alternatives to many things. Exactly, yes.
I don't know
potato bread, that's one of the things.
Honestly, I don't know why we've gotten away from it. I think I do know why. It's because corporate media, corporate America has just forced us to buy. I mean, they put ads in our faces constantly. It's like a brainwashing.
Mm-hmm.
It's to the point that there's and I was one of those people to think that it's not safe if it doesn't come from a store.
Yep. Yeah. See, North Shore, been eating my press for a year now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what a lot of people think we're preppers are prepping for, you know, a zombie apocalypse, the end of the world. No, it can be something this simple. Inflation is so high that you have to save money somewhere. Well, guess what? We have enough food for a year, so there's our savings.
I can tell you this much. For more than a decade, Amy and I have been aware and starting to putting things into practice to make a different lifestyle that's away from the mainstream and not so much, you know, chasing the American dream like we all were sold.
Mm-hmm.
Where to chase a more self-sustainable lifestyle, maybe even not so much call it prepping, but just to be prepared for who knows what. And we got a lot of flack over that. You know, we were mocked, and now those same people who made fun of us or, you know, looked at us like we have two heads are slyly asking us questions on how to go forward. So, but now is not the time to say, I told you so, because that doesn't help anybody.
We're still selling elderberry starts. Locally, yes. As far as shipping them,
shipping has gotten so expensive. It would be
ridiculous. The cost of shipping, we don't make hardly anything off of the elderberry cuttings.
Before the price, yeah. Before the shipping prices went up.
And it was costing us, what, almost $20 to ship them. It's getting ridiculous. And everything is going up and up and up and up. So don't call it prepping, call it common sense. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, you notice the difference between a conspiracy theory and the truth? Nowadays, it's only like a couple of days. Used to be about 6 months.
Veronica said, learn the hard way. Heart attack and family, then Hurricane Harvey, and now this. I try to teach all that I can. Hey, and learn even more.
Christine.
Awesome.
By the way, thank you to our channel members. They're the ones that show up green in the chat. And thank you for the hard work that the moderators do. They're the ones that show up blue in the chat. Thank you.
I would not trust the live plant to survive a trip into the delivery truck. We were actually doing it with the starts. We were able to do them. But the problem right now is not only the cost, but there's so many delays in the postal service that beforehand, like a few years ago when we were doing them, I think it was last year when we did some, I could almost guarantee that package was going to get to you within 2 to 3 days.
Yeah, you can't guarantee
now
that kind of stuff.
Now, I anymore. Might be able to tell you that you may get it in 2 to 3 weeks. Yeah, I mean, it's that wishy-washy.
God Soldiers, hello and welcome.
Sorry, I needed a coffee refill.
I do too. Would you mind? Or...
Oh, Lord.
I can do it.
Give it here.
So another tidbit that I found in the you guys might find interesting. Genetically engineered mosquitoes are about to be released in Florida and California. That's funded by the Bill Gates Foundation. You know, the creepy guy who's obsessed with depopulation.
I'll just go buy one of those battery, those solar powered bug zappers.
What could possibly go wrong?
Did you make a full pot of coffee?
It was short by just a little bit. Abby got a cup too.
Oh, that's where it all went.
Why mosquitoes? The premise of it is, from what I understood, was the genetically modified mosquitoes, they're introducing them into the mosquito population to breed with other mosquitoes and make them sterile or something or other, something like that. But when you start messing with DNA,
yeah.
Thank you.
You released the mosquitoes last year in Florida too. I'd heard they were going to. I never heard whether they did or not.
Yeah, I never knew for sure that they did before.
Perennial veggies and herbs. I actually heard that some people here in Louisiana overwintered some of their peppers in pots. Mm-hmm. And they're still making peppers.
Heirloom perpiculture.
Oh, Lori just sent me a link for somebody that's got elderberries for sale. The plants.
Oh, cool. Got any tips for starting dillweed from seed? Dillweed is not one that we have.
I will be planting some, so.
Okay. We haven't grown any yet.
Right? I just put them in. I did grow some a couple years ago, and I just threw them in a pot. The caterpillars eat them.
I don't remember that.
Yeah. Yes.
That's the good kind of caterpillars eat.
Yeah, it's monarchs, yeah. And stuff that are, I guess it's.
No, it's not monarchs. It's should be swallowtail, I believe.
Okay, maybe it's the swallowtail. Big giant caterpillars, and like in a day, your plant is gone, and then the caterpillars disappear because they ran out of lunch. So, if you're going to grow dill.
Veronica's asking for the link.
make sure that you plant enough to...
Oh, look, Simply Jan. Do you have a link, Jan? Or are you selling those? Or if you have a link...
We have, a ton store, of them.
If you have an online store and you're willing to share or whatever, I'll give you privileges so that you can share your link.
Monarchs eat milkweed, yeah.
Or is
it, it's a type of caterpillar. It's a big giant. Prepared Christian says, I have elderberry cuttings I will share for free. Oh,
there you go.
Yeah, please, please get with these people.
By all means, we are a community.
I just, share. I can't see, I've priced the shipping and stuff, and it's going to be ridiculous, and there's no guarantee that I can ship them and get them to you in time. It's not about the money. I don't want to have to charge $30 for shipping.
We like to offer success.
Right.
And when we can't, if there's not a good chance that we can provide success, then I'd rather not do it.
I just send them for free. I don't charge to send them unless it's overseas.
Okay, there you go. So Mary Ruth is looking for elderberry cuttings. Simply Jan Homestead and the Prepared Christian are both offering elderberry cuttings. So if you guys could just kind of share, get together some kind of way, that's good. And that's a way that we can help, you know?
Yeah.
I feel better about that than potentially shipping something that may not make it. Or
I think some of the prices, the boxes that we were using, but I don't.
Yeah, I'm just not sure the best way. We're kind of reinventing the wheel, I guess, because we're just figuring stuff out as we go.
Yeah.
Now, we do have the elderberry syrup kits on our Etsy store.
Right.
Henry, that's your cue.
Stop.
We do have an Etsy store. And
yeah, if anybody has a link or an email that they would like to share.
That's some yard.
On the elderberry cuttings to get with you about, by all means, please do so.
I'm trying to, I can't say that. Bub, you almost got me.
I know better now. Got dumped from Wi-Fi twice. Third time's a charm. Oh, man.
Oh yeah, only mods can drop links. Well, yeah. That's true.
Oh, fix that.
What?
Make her a mod. I told you to do that the other day.
Okay. Michigan Daffodil is now a moderator.
And what was the other one? Did you change Henry's?
Yep, I fixed him up. There he is.
See? I did tell him. I did tell him.
Okay. Mind and Body Co. just shared a link. That is a link to our Etsy store. So if you're interested and you have... we have all sorts of stuff. We have our logo on different things. Plus, we've got the elderberry syrup kit, like a DIY do-it-yourself syrup making kit. What else do we have on there? The cross necklaces that I make out of horseshoe nails.
We have T-shirts and yeah.
Are we expecting a freeze this weekend? It's going to be borderline.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Saturday night, Sunday morning, it was showing a low of 30. Now it's showing 33. So more than likely, it's going to be at least a frost, if not a freeze.
Wait, the Prepared Christian said your kits are perishable like cuttings are. Actually, no, that's all dried ingredients.
The kits, yeah. The kits are dehydrated elderberries and spices.
Yeah.
Technically, it's perishable. But unless it gets caught in the mail for like 15 years.
The reason that it doesn't as much to ship those is because it's like.
He corrected. He said are not perishable.
Right.
Okay. So we're having a conversation.
But those are much cheaper to ship because it's lightweight. When we're doing the cuttings, we have a little cup of soil with them and they have to stay moist. So it's a little bit tricky because if they're in the mail for too long and they dry out, then you paid $20 for dead sticks. And I don't want to do that. I hate
that. I almost missed you. Good to have you. Good to see you here. back to the news for a second. Where's Fauci? Homeboy gone.
We should name him Waldo.
Yeah, right. So I read actually that there was a reporter who did the FOIA request. FOIA, F-O-I-A, stands for Freedom of Information Act, on Fauci's income and all that stuff. And shortly after he published his findings, your boy disappeared. We don't see him anymore. Long Road Farms, suburban hillbilly. Welcome.
My research this week shows one barrel of refined oil yields 20 gallons only of gasoline.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
So what about...
I heard in protective custody. That's possible.
Who knows? Who knows at this point?
That parody video you did at the gas station a while back might be real soon.
Seriously.
I hope not.
It's looking like it. So, trending on Twitter today.
You have a Twitter?
No, but I saw this article. Was a hashtag. Hashtag Trump was right about everything. And here's something else I found. It says, it's also fake that the minute an outsider took office, we got cheap gas, cheap food, became energy independent, no wars, and focused on our own country's issues. Establishment hacks get back in, and we have inflation, medical tyranny, World War III, and need to take out a mortgage for gas.
Yeah. Okay, Katie decided it's her night to message me.
Oh,
she's
our daughter, Katie.
Yeah, she's in Oregon, so. She is visiting her grandparents and flew all the way from Tennessee to Oregon by herself. So,
did you know the Durham investigation is still ongoing? Mainstream media don't want you to know.
Oh, I bet. Long Road Farm says, glad I'm not doing lawn service this year. Gas would be a killer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And see, we're going to have to cut back on things like that. You know, we're not going to be able to cut grass just whenever we feel like it or we're bored.
All right. Let's see. Let's see if we can get that like button up to 50. I like to see that. I was looking back on our past live streams, and for the past about year, I don't think we've had any under 50. So we're getting there.
What? Top of Louisiana is expecting snow Friday night.
Oh my goodness.
They better stay up on top.
There we go. You guys did it. We're over 50. Appreciate that. I didn't expect it that quick. Thank you.
Oh, man. Put gas for $3.44 today. Thought I hit the jackpot, right?
So the trucker convoy, we got to see the southernmost leg of it, which was, it was a small portion of the convoy, but they were going to meet the other guys.
You need an ice scraper. I have some.
That was Saturday morning. Yeah.
Michigan daffodils in this notes.
Saturday morning, they passed through here along Interstate 10. And we live streamed from the side of the interstate. We were out there. Mary, you're getting ahead of me. So the trucker convoy was going to Washington, D.C.
They're there.
Either they changed their plans or they never intended to enter the city to begin with. They have been circling the city on the Beltway. And today, Ted Cruz joined them. He was riding with them. So what I heard on the radio about the circling of DC is they're going to circle for 7 days. 7 days they're going to circle the city. Now, any of you Bible readers, are you familiar with what this is referring to?
We waited for the convoy up here in Shreveport. They never came. They got held up in Texarkana.
Oh, no. That stinks. So it's a reference to the walls of Jericho. There you go. The Jericho walls. Yeah. So on the seventh day, they blew the trumpet and the walls around Jericho fell. So I've lost track of days. Maybe somebody here can help me. On the seventh day, I intend
they're going to be circling the city and they're going to blow all of their horns. There's supposed to be horns, clappers, all kinds of stuff going on.
Just making noise.
Right.
Yeah.
What they're asking everybody else to do is for that seventh day, take some time out and pray.
Pray.
Everybody come together in prayer. And hopefully we get somewhere. You're talking about millions of people around just the United States coming together in prayer. Mm-hmm. That could have a huge impact.
There was when we were along the interstate with, we're just in a small rural area of Southwest Louisiana.
Rural, as in like Lacassine has 800 people.
Yeah.
They're spread out all over the place.
It's country. And there was at least 24 people out there with us.
It's not more than that, yeah.
If not more. There was a good little turnout in this one little section. And all along the route.
I'm going to try.
But it was really nice. It was great to be out there supporting something that's meaningful with like-minded people. Do you know how much? Because when we protest, there's no mostly peaceful fires. There's no mostly peaceful Molotov cocktails and craziness. It's love and hugs and just talking about gardening. What day are they on now? I would like to know too, because I've lost track.
I'm looking it up. I'm trying to see if I can find it. Yeah, I met up with Ted Cruz. And he's riding in the truck.
He's riding with him, yeah. Ted Cruz. So here's another thing. United Airlines.
He said 1,000 truckers and more are coming every day.
United Airlines will allow 2,200 unjabbed workers on leave to resume their jobs. Think about that. All these people who were put on leave for refusing the jab are now, they're asking them to come back. Mm-hmm. Lippy says, so tomorrow is the day. Tomorrow is the D-Day.
Is it? I'm looking for... know they're gonna be making up two lanes. So
Carol out of Fishes and Loaves Life. If we don't just pull out of these, we still know who wins. We're still gonna be better off. So
really, I'm trying to find the updated post.
We're trying to be sure about you, Dawn.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, Lippy, are you asking or are you saying, are you letting us know that tomorrow's the day? I'm so confused right now. Just saying, keep prepping. Yeah, for sure. Oh, the angry prepper is moving to Texas instead of trying to get back on the NYC fire department. That's good to know. I saw that
hopefully it's this side of
the Los Angeles dropped the whole you don't have to be jabbed to go anywhere anymore. In Los Angeles.
But they're not asking for
the passport.
Yeah.
Let's see. What else do I have here?
Oh, gosh. Why is this so freaking hard to find?
All right. So, hey, question for you guys. Before Mount Everest was discovered, what was the highest point on Earth? Hey, Gardner Josh.
What?
Before Mount Everest was discovered, what was the highest point on Earth?
Oh, that's easy. Okay. Right. March 7th. Was the second day.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12, the 12th should be the Suburban Hillbilly. Before Mount Everest was discovered, the highest point on Earth was still Mount Everest, which goes to prove that not knowing the facts doesn't change the truth. Now keep that in mind as we start to hear things changing about the Russia-Ukraine situation over the next few days, because I'm hearing some things, reading some things that aren't making it to the mainstream news that would I obviously cannot share here on YouTube, nor is that I know that I would, because at this point, I don't even know if it's the truth. Okay.
Yeah, it's March 7th. It says the trucker went to the highway that circles around D.C. for the second day. So, yeah, so we should be the 12th. And this was on March 7th. It was posted, and they said the convoy was 12 miles long. Now, I did read somewhere that they were only taking up one lane.
Right. Because if they don't impede traffic and they're simply driving around the city, they're not breaking the law.
I think it's tomorrow that they're taking two lanes of the three. Okay. They're gonna go in two lanes, but they're still not driving slow enough to impede, to completely stop traffic, so they can't do too much with them. But they are, you know, they are in talks with Congress. They are in talks with, you know, some of these big names in DC. So they're trying to do things the right way. And I really applaud them for that.
Now, thank you, Henry, for posting our backup channel on Rumble, because we've been getting a little edgy lately. It's probably a matter of time before we get censored. Now, on the topic of truth, let's see. Perspective Vision says the convoy is doing nothing, just a rally and a tailgate party. I hope you're wrong. Can't say that you are. I don't know. Now, on the topic of the truth, whether you know the truth or not doesn't change the truth. I just, right before we started the stream tonight, I saw a headline that says Russia is calling for a meeting with the UN Security Council over the U.S. biological activities in Ukraine.
Kaylin posted, from what I've seen, the mask requirements for all forms of public transportation may end March 18th, but I'm not certain on that date. I did find out yesterday.
Say love.
Our local parish schools, Raylingham School, they are no longer required mask in school or on buses. She is so happy.
Yeah. Well, I mean, all this time, you know, for 2 years, we said masks do nothing, and we got, you know, fact-checked and thrown off of platforms, and then all of a sudden, we were right.
Yeah, I've seen something about that by your dog. She's talking about crisis actor events going on, some fake movie scenes, taking years film footage from other places. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Past videos and using them as current news. Yeah, I don't know too much about that, though.
So they've admitted that there are bio research labs in Ukraine.
Lippy said, I was in a federal building yesterday getting my license and no mask was required. That's awesome.
So they have admitted to bio research labs in Ukraine. Do you know where else there is a bio research lab? Wuhan. Think about it. There's a whole lot of us.
Are you right, Sean? North Shore, if you can smell a fork through it, dot, dot, dot.
there's a lot of us, including myself, who are just not ready to hear that the United States might be the bad guys here. But remember, it's not the United States people. It's not the Americans. They're not the American people. Just like if Russia's the bad guy, the Russian people are not the government.
Well, even still, not everyone is bad and not everyone is good. There has to be some discernment there.
That's right.
You know, not all Christians are good people. And are you...
I like to say there's assholes in every group. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter who it is.
Have you tested that with forks in our house? Yes.
Yeah, we call that a COVID test.
I'll be right back. I'm going to message Katie.
Okay.
And,
all right. This says something is a conspiracy, it's likely true. Yeah, you're probably right about that.
Hey, we can stay kind of late tonight.
We can hang out for a little while. I'm still in the middle of a time off, so we're good to go. Mama Bear. Yeah. In Louisiana, we are a red state with a blue governor, which I don't know how that happened. I don't think any of us know the whole story. I don't care where you live. You're absolutely right. And we may never know the whole story, which is why we should look at things with an open mind. Recently, I was accused of. Well, first of all, I'm not even on Truth Social yet. I haven't been allowed in yet. Still on the waiting list. But I was accused of it being an echo chamber. And as a matter of fact, someone on Twitter said that Truth Social is an echo chamber. And I thought, well, that's pretty ironic, because you're on the platform who silences everyone with a dissenting opinion and calling the other platform the echo chamber. I don't know about that. Love the live of y'all on the interstate. Yeah, that was a lot of fun. We got to hang out with some like-minded people. It was a really enjoyable time. What is an echo chamber? An echo chamber, that's a condescending way of describing a group of people where they just all have the same opinions, and they don't listen to opinions from outside of that group, if that makes sense. So basically, you're getting your own opinion echoed back to you from the other people in the group. My Pine Tree Hill says, my opinion is that the Democratic America is the whore of Babylon. They flaunt the riches of the country to the rest of the world as the land of opportunity and success in order to profit and gain power. If you're going to talk about flaunting riches, I agree. I do not disagree with your statement, but there is another entity in the world who flaunts riches and has power, and this is probably going to hurt some people, but that would be the Vatican. All right, Miss Lippy, have a good night.
What we forgot to mention.
What did we forget to mention? But does not have commerce like America does. Good point.
Pantry was giving away sweet potatoes.
And nobody was going to get them.
Nobody wanted them, apparently. They had a huge bin of them.
So to keep from throwing them away.
Well, they put a thing on Facebook that my mom happened to spot. I swear she's got an eye for that stuff. But basically, come get as many as you can, because what's still here is going to be thrown out. And they're perfectly good. Now, a few of them might be broken or, you know, have some bad spots on them or whatever. But we ended up with two boxes of these. Pretty good sized boxes. So tomorrow is sweet potato canning day.
Yep.
We will be canning up as many as we can.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. Officials and Lowbice says, yay, slips.
Oh.
Well, we can set aside a couple of them to grow slips off of.
Yes. See? And that's why I love this place. Sweet potato flour, yeah.
Okay, Perspective Vision says, nothing in Ukraine justifies what Russia is doing to it or its people.
canning as many as you can. Yeah.
I have to be honest with you. I stay away from the mainstream news, so I don't really know what's happening, but I do not, I most certainly pray for the Ukrainian people and the Russian people who don't want this mess going on. That my stance is not that a war should happen by any means. And whoever's right or wrong, I do pray for the people suffering. I don't know enough about what's going on.
Right.
As far as that goes, I'm ill-informed. I apologize. I'm glad you're here, Perspective Visions. I'm glad you're here to share your information. Or your,
Mama Z, are you doing sweet potatoes? Are you doing them in syrup? Or are you going to do them just in water? Because I think I'm going to try to do them without the syrup. Just because I try to watch my blood sugar, I'd rather not.
Jackie, that's where I'm. That's where I stand stuff. With mainstream news. It's so hard to know what's the truth, what's fiction, what's, you know, just narrative, what's completely made up. Do you watch constant? No, I don't. I don't. Most of what I learn comes from Telegram and Rumble.
I think just some water. I don't know. I may do both ways.
And I do have to discern and go through and I can't just trust everything. I'm just going to say that.
Right. One question, Mama Z, if you just can them in water, do you have to blend or can you just throw them in the jars, add your hot water and can them? I'm not understanding why they would need to be blanched because they're going to be cooked in the pressure canner for an hour and a half.
I don't know. Maybe somebody who's...
That's what... Yeah. Maybe. Well, Mama Z's doing...
Okay. Gary B.
I would just can them. Oh, so no kneading. I think the blanching is to cut some of the starch off of them. So it's not cloudy looking in the jars. I don't care what they look like, as long as they're safe to eat and they taste. Yep, because they get very cloudy.
Here we go. We've got 50, I'm showing 56 thumbs up. Let's see if we can get it to 60.
Okay.
I said that a while ago about getting it to 50.
Blanching them makes them too mushy. See, that's what I was thinking, Dee.
Let's see what we can do.
And cut out the black spots too. Okay.
Don't read this out loud. Okay. Oh, really?
We cook our sweet potatoes in an Instant Pot, but I've never canned any. I haven't canned them. So this is going to be my first attempt at canning them. But I really want to try...
Spaghetti squash. We haven't grown any.
No, we haven't grown any ourselves, but we've eaten it. Yeah. Blanching kills enzymes that will continue to ripen produce and such things like potatoes. I understand that, but yeah. If you're canning them, then you're going to be pressure cooking them for an hour and a half inside the jar.
Right. That would kill the enzymes too.
Right.
So I don't understand the point of blanching and then.
Okay. Mary Ruth says, I can for the first time. No blanching turned out great. So that's what I'm thinking is it the blanching process that mom was doing is just to keep the cloudiness down. See, that doesn't bother me. When you get them from the store, they're kind of, it's kind of cloudy and. You know, you just can't, it's because you can't see it through the can that you get at the store because it's a metal can.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessary in canning, only in freezing.
Dehydrated 42 quail eggs. Ran it at 125 for about 7 hours, but had to add time to one tray that was
completely full.
So silicone tray worked great.
Yes.
That's beautiful. Love it.
I never thought about
built on a rock homestead, Kiri. I don't know if I told you hi. I saw you there earlier.
You can
not necessary in canning, only in freezing. I don't know if you saw that one.
Yeah, so I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to blanch them. I'm just going to put them in the jars and do it that way. They have an Instant Pot now that cans, that you can can in.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
It was so close to being a pressure canner already.
Yeah, well, it's a pressure cooker, but...
Yeah, right.
Yeah. I wish I was physically able to grow a garden, but not able. I would love to grow some patty pan squash. Can you grow in containers? Maybe.
Dehydrating sweet potatoes works well, too. I imagine it would.
We've done that.
We've done sliced potatoes. No, you've done sweet potatoes?
I've done sweet potatoes and turned it into powder.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I've got allergy eyes. And I can't put put drops in my eyes while I'm wearing my contacts, so I'm just kind of out of luck.
Why?
I'm not taking out my contacts. I can't see the chat.
You put saline in your eyes as drops.
Yeah, but that's not. I've got a twitch in my eye too, like my eyelid goes.
I've been canning in an old school Instant Pot for over a year. Long experiment, and I've yet to reveal the results of. Oh.
Welcome, buddy. Oh, Pathways Homestead is here.
How in the world do you get it to power in your humid environment? Wait, get what to power?
I'm not sure what you're
pushing. Powder.
Powder.
Okay. I use a dehydrator in the house, and the humidity in the house is not the same because we run the air conditioner all the time. The dogs like sweet potatoes. Sweet potato and pumpkin are really good for the dogs. Yeah, see, saline drops would rinse the eye in context. Yeah.
A twitch or a twinkle. As long as it's not a tinkle. I don't want anybody tinkling in my eye.
Sean is talking to Sean. It's weird. It's hard to keep up.
At least one of them spells it right. Now you guys can fight over who that is.
It's Sean and Scene. I love it.
Speaking of Sean at North Shore Preparedness, do you still have that live stream scheduled? If so, the one that I did for you by accident, if so, I need to get with you, or you need to go and turn it to private.
Eye twitches can be caused by fatigue.
Oh, and stress, and I'm sure, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, the one thing we didn't talk about is the dishwasher.
Oh, man. The dishwasher. So we have a dishwasher. Okay. Let me start there. And the other day, I'm going to just let that one go. That's great. So the other day, we've got a double wide trailer.
It's a manufactured.
A double wide manufactured home, which I've said before is just a swanky way of saying a Siamese trailer house. But anyway, the appliances that came with it,
I agree,
were kind of subpar at best. And we had replaced everything except for the dishwasher. And we've been here 7 years, almost 7 years now in this home. We had it built for us. So his name is Keith.
I have a dishwasher too, of them actually. So, they grew up though and now have kids of their own.
So the other day, which I'll be honest with you, I don't mess with the dishwasher too much. I normally, and it's not an old fashioned thing. It's just the way that it works out in our house. Amy and Abby normally take care of the dishes.
We load the dishwasher every night. We only run it once a day in the evenings. And we load it throughout the day and then we run it at night. And
the other day I was unloading the dishwasher. And
the night before it smelled like burnt plastic.
It did. Something smelled kind of funky.
We didn't realize it
was. So I was unloading the dishwasher and the bottom. What is it?
The spinny water
spray
bar
thing on the bottom. I don't know what you call it, but the part that spins and sprays the water, the lower one. Okay. I noticed it looked weird. It wasn't centered. And I was like, well, that's an odd design. Anyway. So I reach in there and I try to spin it and I realize that it had come off and was laying on the heating element. Two points were on the heating element and the heating element had melted almost all the way through it. So I got to thinking, you remember the other day when the breaker tripped and you thought it was for this other stuff and it was actually the dishwasher breaker?
Would that be the water spraying arm? Yeah, probably.
That was probably keeping us from burning this sucker down. So, almost $1,000 later, I'm sitting in the middle of the kitchen cussing at a dishwasher.
Well, the instruction booklet wasn't that great, and he couldn't find the connections to the new dishwasher.
The instruction booklet that came with it, okay, somehow or another, there was a page in there that got folded funny at the publisher, or I don't know, whoever assembled this stupid book. And I couldn't see it. Like, it was folded. Look, I'm thinking about it, and I'm getting pissed off. And anyway, the book was one of those, it's like a generic book. It's like we bought Bosch this particular model number, and the book was like, well, for just most Bosch models are.
Well, the problem was none of the hoses were fitting right. We couldn't find the connectors that were supposed to be there. And like we're going through all the packing material and everything. The hose was inside the dishwasher.
I took a hose off of the side of the thing. I thought it was just there I thought it was stored there and needed to come off for me to attach to the other hose. So I was.
the book was built at the drug rehab center.
More than likely. It was probably built by some addicts, at least.
Wait, nothing like the firefighter's water spraying device catching fire.
Oh, man. You just added a whole layer to this thing, girl. Prep for eternity, Brother Donnie. Good to see you. So at one point, I'm just so aggravated. I'm cussing. I'm walking around. I was cussing.
Yeah.
I'm a fireman. I know the words. So I use them every once in a while.
A lot the other night. Quite a lot.
I was a little bit aggravated. So so I'm looking around. I'm the book is just thrown to the wayside because it's completely useless. I'm back and forth to my shed several times getting tools. You were a huge help. Huge help. She did a lot of the trips back and forth to the shed. And I was like, oh, I need a screwdriver and I don't have it. And she was, she went get it. Anyway, so at one point, I was like, Wait a second. These hoses are not, there's no way.
Read Sean's comment.
Hey, how to garden. Oh, man. That's a good way to get thrown out of this chat. Seen in Alaska.
Stop it.
Just messing around. Oh, he knows it. So these hoses weren't fitting together. There was no way. I was like, what in the hell? The book is no help. So finally, I was like, wait. I opened the dishwasher, and there it is in a nice little...
Oh, yeah, it was all looped together.
Pretzel-looking sucker was the hose that I needed.
With the connector pieces that we were looking for on the ends of the hose.
Tidy little hose. So had I known that that was in there and just completely just burned the book as soon as I got started, then what took me 2.5 hours would have taken me 15 minutes.
Well, there should be, you know, they got little yellow stickers on all this thing stuff. Why can't they put a sticker on the front of the thing that says open for extra parts?
Yeah. Hose up in here. So another thing too, our old dishwasher, the one that we took out, was hardwired. And if you don't know what that means, the wire came out of the wall into a box that is part of the dishwasher and just wire nutted on. There's no plug, right? Mm-hmm. The new one didn't have that option. It had a plug, like a power cord that plugged into the back of the machine of the dishwasher, and it needed to be plugged in, and I didn't have an outlet, and I had bare wires.
Luckily,
so
the last time we had electrical work that needed to be done, I had the bright idea, let's get some more outlets.
You're so wise.
Pick up some more parts in case something else goes wrong.
That's just a smart thing to do, guys. So, yeah. So she had to go get the parts that I had to tell her. I need a box. I need an outlet.
You didn't have to tell me.
I need an outlet cover. She's like, do you need wire nuts? No, I got that. And anyway, inside the whole, I don't know what just happened there. I'm good. Inside the hole where the dishwasher goes, I had to climb in there and install an outlet.
Exactly. The book should have said hose in washer. I read the book.
Exactly.
I read the instructions, started at page one and went all the way through the instructional portion of it. The other half of the book was in some other language. Couldn't even tell you which one, but that's one thing I was looking for is the location of the freaking parts, because I was looking through plastic and there was pieces of styrofoam and little bags all over of screws and stuff. But this hose was nowhere to be found, and neither was the connectors. If they would have put a sticker on the front of the book that says "Look inside dishwasher for parts,"
yeah,
you know, it would have made it so much easier. A whole lot less colorful metaphors would have come out of his mouth.
Colorful metaphors.
That Mama Bear said that earlier.
Oh, I just noticed we were up to 60 thumbs up. Thank you guys, appreciate that. What was I gonna say? Oh no, I already said that. Wow.
You just had a whole conversation inside your head, didn't you?
No, I think that pretty much summed up the whole dishwasher fiasco. That was crazy.
Oh, Christy. So that makes me think of the first turkey I cooked. I didn't know there was a bag of stuff inside.
Oh no.
Yikes.
What else we got going on? We already talked about moving the building, country boy style. You got seedlings coming up
everywhere.
That's cool. We had a couple of people get with us, a couple of locals, about some strawberries and comfrey, and we haven't been able to meet up yet, but that's in the works. So we're going to be able to share some plants. What a blessing.
Abby's prom dress is in, and we're going tomorrow to get some alterations done on it.
This weekend, Saturday, we're going to go tour a college campus with Abby. So that'll be fun.
It'll be long.
Yeah. So if you're in the Lafayette area, Lafayette, Louisiana, and you're interested in trying to meet up, give us a shout. See what we can do.
Unless the extra outlets overloaded the circuits causing the breaker tripping. No, the dishwasher is on its own breaker. And I think what caused it to trip is the fact that it was melting.
I'm pretty sure the melted plastic inside of the thing is what caused it to trip the breaker. Surely, right?
I thought it was the same breaker for the lights that we were having trouble with. Because the internet went out that day.
Yeah, but it was a different breaker and you didn't.
Yeah.
Saturday night, time change. This is true.
Is it?
We do know Southern Boy Prepper. We have met up with Reagan and we didn't know him before he had YouTube, though. We met through YouTube, so that was really cool.
My ceilings come up great, then they go limp and die. they probably need some sunshine. Do you have a light on?
There could be any number of things. Could be overwatering, could be underwatering, could be too much light, could be...
Now, most people don't know that you need to put the light on during the day and would turn it off at night, especially with tomatoes and peppers. They need night, like periods of no light.
Another thing.
This Saturday, yes.
Before we finish up the dishwasher, I just remembered too.
Saturday night, Sunday morning.
Where the wire comes up through the floor. When we first moved here, see, we cleared part of a field to put our house here and develop the land. So it went from an overgrown field to a yard with a house in it. So the mice that we took there, we took their habitat. They needed a place to live. So
they were trying to take it back.
So for the first year or so before we got a cat, we had a mouse problem here in the house. And when I took the old dishwasher out, there was a flat mummified mouse in there. And where the wire comes through the floor was chewed. Only the outer insulation of the wire, though. So I was able to just electrical tape and have to splice the wire. Thank goodness, because that would have been a mess. But also, while we had the dishwasher out, here's a hack in case you don't know. If you do have mouse problems, if you've got holes where they can, if they can fit their nose through it, way in. So a good way to prevent that is stuff steel wool in the hole. They can't chew through it. And if they are able to bite pieces off of it and they ingest that, then that's another way that you won't have a mouse problem. Because that's sharp.
It's metal, yeah.
Sure. What was that? Sound like a gunshot.
Probably.
We are in the country. Mice love to come in around dishwashers.
Yeah.
Any plumbing, anything where there's a hole that goes through a wall or a floor. Plumbing, electrical, drain, you know, all that stuff.
Let's see. Yeah, Mama Bear, they have to have no, they need darkness hours too. I normally turn the light off when I go to bed and then I turn it on again in the morning when I get up. Chrissy said I'm officially an old lady on Saturday and I get Medicare.
Oh, dryer vents, yes.
I might steal it to smoke.
Don't say that. Steel wool, if it comes in contact with wiring. Yes, that is true. That is true. And that's because steel wool is so fine. It's like a tiny wire. And because if you try to put too much voltage or amperage, I forget, there's so many, Is it volts? Is it amps? Is it ohms? Is it, you know, watts? I forget. Okay. But if you try to put too much electricity through something that's too small, then it creates heat and thereby a fire. So if you have a junk drawer, like many of us here in Louisiana do, I've never lived elsewhere. I don't know if that's a thing elsewhere, but do not put your 9-volt batteries and your steel wool in the same drawer, because they can, if steel wool, 9-volt battery has two prongs on the same side, same end of the battery. And if it touches the steel wool like that, it can cause a fire.
It will cause a fire.
It will. Yes, it will. Simply, Jane, you have to go. That's all right. Have a great night.
Son and daughter went to Southeastern in Hammond.
Amperage. Thank you, Warren.
See, that's on the other side. Abby's looking to go to UL. It's University of Louisiana Lafayette. I'm trying to convince her to go to McNeese and Lake Charles, just because it would be closer and it would cost less. But, you know, ultimately that's her choice and her student loan. Okies have junk drawers. I've had them in Wyoming and Kansas too. Okay, so it's not just the Cajun thing. I had no idea.
I wasn't sure. There's some things that I'm just talking like everybody does it. And then I find out that that's a local thing and I didn't know. I'm trying not to get the... You got that print.
I don't even care. It itches. Okay. Bayou Dawn says, we put peppermint and tea tree oil in the garden spray bottle. We spray all the way around the house before a freeze to keep them away. We spray inside too. Somebody told me about peppermint oil on a cotton ball.
Gary.
So I thought, okay, awesome. I can do that. I put peppermint oil on cotton balls and threw them all in cabinets all over. It smelled wonderful in here. It really did. They ate the cotton ball.
Yeah, so, I mean, I swear, we've got like...
So, next step, we got a cat.
Robo mice and freaking...
They ate the cotton ball.
Robo fire ants. Like, they just...
You missed it.
These pests around here, y'all, they just...
Okay, I gotta go use the wall for a second.
Cajun mice, minty fresh cotton balls. Yeah. See, ate the cotton ball. They surely did. We put them in the little in mesh bags. What kind of bags was that? Cheesecloth.
Cheesecloth.
There you go.
I made little bags out of cheesecloth. So that they were, you know, kind of open.
Yeah.
So the scent was everywhere, y'all. It smelled minty fresh.
It went in all the cabinets, under the bathroom sinks, in those cabinets, and
Yeah.
They ate them.
They ate crayons in my junk drawer.
Peppermint mixed with plaster of Paris. That makes sense.
Wow.
So you have little mice statues.
Oh gosh. Oh, Michigan Daffodil, thanks for coming. Talking with you through the week.
What's the difference between Cajun and Creole? I just recently found this out and I feel bad because I may have been insensitive before, and if I was, apologize, but I found out that Cajun is the people from Acadia in France, which used to be it now it's Nova Scotia, that area, when they were expelled from, anyway, they came down here. That's Cajun. Creole, I found out, is a mix of the Cajun and the Haitian, and so it's multi multi-race, multicultural. Mm-hmm. So I consider my, I consider myself more Creole as far as culture goes, but probably Cajun as far as actual race.
Heritage, yeah.
If that makes sense.
Yeah.
Because the Creole...
my statues.
The
being politically correct, Brent.
I enjoy a lot of the Creole influences in the Cajun culture, Cajun Creole culture.
Wow. We had to tie peanut butter in cheesecloth to the rat traps, and then tie the rat traps down so they didn't go missing. That's... Golly. We have some rat traps in the feed room.
Yeah.
And
we have a couple of them that came from
Big Bear.
Big Bear Homestead.
And we had, yeah, they're screwed to the wall.
I had to take a piece of wire.
Yeah.
And attach these things so that they wouldn't disappear. And we caught a rat in each one, mm-hmm. and then never reset them. So it's our fault. We've been far more successful just by resetting the dang trap.
A little mice museum. Oh, this is great. Culturally, I'm a redneck Cajun in South Louisiana. Oh, man. That's great. My Dotson was an excellent mouser, but the little guy's almost 18 years. Oh, wow.
Cool.
Yeah, see, we've got... Chloe is, what, 13, 14 years old?
Yeah, Chloe's our chihuahua.
She couldn't see the mouse if it ran past her. And she can't hear it if it made a noise.
She'd probably be like, so, and just keep on walking.
Now, the cat, on the other hand, if it moves, she's going to get it.
Yeah, our cat, Lily, she's still young. She's probably, what, maybe 4 years old. I don't remember exactly when we got Lily, but she's an inside only cat, and today she made it out of the house. She darted out, and she doesn't try to go anywhere. She's after the lizards.
The lizard is taunting
that
her.
That hang out on along the side of the house and around our porches and stuff.
No, so that lizard, I had the front door open because it's beautiful today. So it's a solid glass door and she can see the porch. And this lizard is hanging out in front of her on the other side of the glass and like just wiggling around and, you know, like, ha ha ha, you can't get me. Well, when the door opened, it was game on.
So, do we cook Cajun or more Creole? I'm not sure. I'm not sure. If it's delicious, I like it. So, I mean,
I'm not
sure which
like
dishes
tonight,
fall
Abby
into
made
which category.
Spaghetti with sausage in it.
Sausage, yeah, like Rabidoo sausage. Rabidoo is a local meat market to us. So
people don't know what Rabidoo sausage is.
Well, you're missing out.
It's not like summer sausage.
It's a sausage link, and it's smoked heavily. Man, it's delicious.
It's spicy. But I mean, like,
we don't put tomatoes in gumbo.
No.
Some people do. I think that's a Creole thing. Not a fan.
I bet the flower children had stolen.
But I do like tomatoes. I don't know if that's a Creole thing, but I do like tomatoes in okra, like smothered okra. I like
my mama told me about a recipe to make.
I
like eggplant dressing, but with okra.
Oh, well, that'll work. I like that. I love eggplant dressing. I like catfish.
What?
Coubillon. What?
Mary?
The Cajun food and the Creole food are really, really similar, except the Creole food uses a lot more tomato based.
Right.
Creole uses more tomato stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
No carrots in gumbo either.
Do you put okra in your gumbo? Sometimes. Not everybody who lives here, like Abby, my teenage daughter, who's picky about some things. She does not like okra in the gumbo, so oftentimes we don't put the okra in the gumbo.
I found boudin at my Aldi's this weekend.
Wait, no carrots in gumbo. Who put? Never mind. Never mind.
No.
Had my first Boudin a few months ago. Almost died and went to heaven. Boudin is the bomb.
It's got to be Louisiana made, though, in order to be, like, true.
Anglo-Saxon in Florida, I just now associate with being burnt. I'm not, what?
I don't know.
Carol, you tell me riddles all the time. I got to decode. Yeah. Carol knows I'm joking.
You guys drank all the coffee.
Did you have a cup?
Yeah, but I only got a half.
Okay, then we drank all the coffee. You are we.
How many cups did you guys have?
Two each?
That's what I thought.
Is that your second cup? Then you had two cups.
It's not even a full cup.
It doesn't matter. It's your second cup.
It didn't even make a full cup.
You had two.
No, I had one and maybe a half because it didn't even fill it halfway.
That is a whole cup. That is not a half cup.
Yeah, but it filled halfway.
Hey, stop.
Oh my God, you're annoying.
Okay, people are saying they don't like the slime. We do have a video on how to smother down the okra, and it takes the slime out of it.
I just got it.
It was from Louisiana. Awesome. I'm going to miss.
Hi, everybody.
Sorry, wait.
No, no. We don't get to talk about that.
I was going to prom this week, next weekend, and she tested a tanning lotion?
No, it's a tanning water.
And you can probably see this.
Oh God!
Is it? Let me see. Oh yeah.
So bad.
She trumped herself.
I did it wrong. I didn't follow the instructions correctly. I accidentally went to bed with it on when I was supposed to rinse it off, and it didn't work.
Just tell people it's a birthmark.
A really big birthday, and it's gonna fade in a few days.
Tell people you've been trumped.
Oh. That's so messed up.
The cup is an entire cup, right? Okay, okra, do whatever you do to it. I even like it. See, I like it raw too. And yes, definitely you want to cook down and smother your okra first. It'll take you take out the slime and stuff, because when you cook it slowly, you're going to cook some of that stuff out of there.
Well, it didn't actually. I'm gonna pull up the chair and say something, and talk a bit.
Henry said you're as pale as Michael Jackson.
It doesn't actually stain stuff because it's a clear liquid, which makes it even harder to blend it out.
You want
to
come sit for a minute?
Yeah, sure.
You're leaving?
No. I'm gonna let her sit and talk for a minute.
Bye.
I'm bored, okay?
She only wants to talk to y'all because she's bored.
Oh, don't be rude. But, it's clear, so it doesn't stain anything or get anything else, but, that was pretty good. So it doesn't stain anything else, but it does make it hard to blend because you can't see it. So that's what kind of happened over here, too. It's because, like, I couldn't see where I was going. So I'm trying to get in only a small section. But it didn't work out that well.
Okay. She said, Carol says, no, she's pale like me and my Anglo-Saxon friends. That is why we get red in Florida.
Hmm.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, because, like, I don't tan either. I can go outside and I'll become, like, a ripe tomato.
Or you could just take crawfish boil and rub yourself down.
Warren mentioned fried okra. That stuff is good. I love fried okra.
That's what it is. It's a spray on. It's a spray on water that you just blend in, and it works really well because I retried it on like my leg, and it's really good when you do it correctly. Don't fall asleep in it. But Abby, are you going to take any art classes at college? Kind of depends on what I have the time and money for. If I would love to, if I can, but I'm going to do my needed classes first for my major, and then I'll do my extras if I can.
Christy asked you a question, too. Christy Bits.
You still like to cook? I do.
She cooked us dinner tonight.
I try to cook as much as I can. I just don't have as much time anymore.
What did you call the one last night? Mince?
Mince and dumplings.
Mince. M-I-N-C-E. Mince and dumplings. You said that's a...
Yeah, it's like a UK a dish. It's mainly Yorkshire, I think it is.
It was really good.
What's wrong? You were looking at me weird.
I thought you had something on your shoulder, but it's a hole in your shirt, a little small one.
You have to lower the sunscreen slowly.
We've been on here for almost 2 hours.
Wow. I'm sorry. Wally.
What are you going to major in, Abby?
Pre-law. Political science and pre-law.
Oh, Sean knows what mince is.
So maybe it's just a northern dish. I don't know.
Well, North Shore preparedness was... he also took culinary and was a chef, so...
True. They allow you art credits for your first 2 years of your associates. Cool.
Yeah, she's taking law and going to change the world and fix everything. So you like to argue? Like you would not believe.
No, I want to go... my big dream overall.
Up in Canada, they ruin French fries with gravy.
It actually sounds really good. Okay, I'm just gonna say. But my big dream is to go to political science and go and become a self-injury lawyer, and then branch out with sexual assault cases. And I want to get hopefully a business degree with a pre-law degree at some point, so that I can open my own nonprofit business and work with, or nonprofit law firm to work with sexual assault cases and stuff. If I have the money, because that's expensive. But it's a dream.
It says up, I think I already read that, but up in Canada, they were in French fries with gravy.
Mm-hmm.
They also have a dish that sounds like it would be sewage in a bowl. Poutine.
That's what gravy with the fries is.
Is it?
Yeah. Oh. It's like fries, gravy, cheese curds, and cheese, I think.
It sounds like it would be like a bowl of farts. Mmm.
You're so gross. You're nasty.
Ooh, a Scottish cooking channel.
Sounds yummy.
What are you laughing at out there?
Oh, cool. Mom Z's Texas Kitchen said, "You got this, Abby. Kendra is getting a criminal justice degree. She's going to be doing CSI.
Nice.
I couldn't do it. I couldn't be like on the scenes and stuff like that.
In New York, it's fries with brown gravy at a diner after a night out. I could see it. That does sound good. Fries with brown gravy.
In Belgium, they eat their fries.
I would call it fries and brown gravy.
In Belgium, they eat their French fries with mayonnaise instead of ketchup.
I could see that too.
It's so good. Like, you guys, that's how I eat them now, because I heard that in French class. French class, and I tried it, and it was so good.
Somebody put fries and gravy equals Putin.
I just realized that, yeah.
That's what I was laughing at.
Oh, you know what? Speaking of that, isn't it funny that the guy who's causing all of the gas problems is named Putin?
So dumb.
Made fries.
Yeah, it's delicious. How they eating it, but I shouldn't.
All right, Amy.
only brown switch gravy.
Switch chairs, so Mom can have hers, and I will be right back.
Mm-hmm. Oi.
Oh, Sean put a link for that channel.
Oh, yeah.
So I got it.
With a mayo, ketchup, and a spot of mustard. So you take out the ketchup.
See, mayo, ketchup, and a little mustard is how we make our crawfish dip.
I don't really like the crawfish.
Well, I mean, we had a few other things.
I don't really like the crawfish dip, though. I like the way it came.
We need to do a video on that.
But it has ketchup in that. But
on how to make the crawfish dip.
Oh, yeah. Sure. We could do that. Real quick videos like that.
Mm-hmm.
Easy.
Do it in a short instead.
Well, I mean, I don't necessarily like the short format. With the anyway. Well, we could still make it
fries
short.
And cream gravy are the bomb.
Ooh. That sounds good.
Is that like a white gravy? Because I like French fries with white gravy.
Yeah, I think it is a white gravy.
Yeah.
Getting a little chilly.
Mm-hmm. I want to go gator hunting. Yeah, well.
What if you'd have had the camera ready that day?
I couldn't have the camera ready that day because I was rolling on the ground laughing at you.
He went in the pond with a metal trash can.
No, it was a plastic 55-gallon trash can.
It was
a metal
boat.
In a boat. In a little flat-bottom boat. And had he even caught the thing in the trash can like he was trying to do, the thing is heavy. He would have flipped the boat. He would have been in the water with the alligator, and it ate him. Thanks for coming, J-Love.
Cream gravy and white gravy are the same.
Okay.
See, I love white gravy, but it's taken me a while to be able to even eat it after working at Dairy Queen.
Well, yeah.
Because, the smell of it. Oh.
Oh, man. Yeah, Abby's been trying a bunch of different new recipes and like slow cooker recipes and that Instant Pot chicken stuff that you made the other day was really good.
That was
good.
A slow cooker chicken recipe.
Was it? No.
The lemon one?
No.
Oh.
Whatever you had in the fridge I ate.
Brown sugar and soy sauce.
I don't know, but you made it in the Instant Pot.
With a little bit of cayenne pepper. And it was mashed sweet potatoes on the side. Mm-hmm. Dairy Queen doesn't do it right. Yeah, they don't.
Well, not just that, but when
white gravy. Okay, this is what I never understood because I would always bring it up when we were making it. The white milk gravy was made with water. But the ranch was made with milk. That seems backwards.
Well, it depends on if they were using a mix that had powdered milk in it.
I don't know. I know it was a mix. I don't know if they had powdered milk in it, but it just seems weird.
When you do it right and start it with a proper roux. Yeah.
I've made homemade white gravy before for biscuits and sausage, and it's so good.
Yeah. I thought right white gravy was roux that wasn't cooked enough. No, it is roux, but it's not cooked as long. We do have a roux video. Because me and Kate did that when she was here. I need to do some more of that soon. Oh, that would be a good thing to do with the upcoming cold.
Cold?
No, roux.
Oh.
I need to make some roux and jar it up. Now I'm hungry. I need a chocolate dip cone. Now they have a dip cone that tastes like fruity pebbles.
Oh, yeah. Don't even get me started on that. I do not want to eat it. It's purple.
It's a blonde roux, yeah. Actually, it's pink.
Oh, no, that's not the new one that they're getting then, because there's a purple one.
Well, it's supposed to be purple, but it looks more pink.
Oh, I don't want to eat
dip cone. We used to, my driver's ed instructor when I was in high school, he would have all of us drive through a certain part of town because there was a sign for a dip. And as soon as we'd pass the dip in the road and the sign, he'd say, oh, well, turn here. We're going to go around the Dairy Queen to get a dip cone.
Well, I will say the dip cones at Dairy Queen were probably one of my least favorite things to make, honestly, because, like, you would make it, and then you never knew with the ice cream if it was going to be soft or if it was going to be hard or if it was going to stick to the cone or not. So, like, as you were turning it upside down to dip it, in your mind you were going, don't fall, don't fall, don't fall, don't fall. Because if it fell, you had to grab it with a gloved hand, obviously.
Yeah.
Sanitary. But, and it was just, oh, so gross.
Abby, how's your new job going?
It's pretty good.
Do you get stink bugs down? Yes, we do. Yes, very much so. Stink bugs are probably going to be a problem this year because we didn't really have too many hard freezes this winter. So it is a struggle, but we use diatomaceous earth. And if you can catch them as like the little baby orange looking spider thing, they look like assassin bugs, but they're not. They're slightly different. Diluted Castile soap with water, and you can spray them on there and it kills the babies instantly. So it keeps them under control, but yeah, stink bugs ruin the tomatoes. And I'm really hoping that we can keep them under control until at least until after the tomatoes are done, but I don't know. The bad thing with the Castile soap and water is you've got to be out there almost every day with a sprayer, and just heard a bunch of gunshots out here. Somebody's either a bad shot or they really messed up a coyote.
Oh my god.
Yeah, stink bugs are already here this year. Yes. I'm already seeing them on some of the elderberries and things like that, and they're full grown.
We had one in the house the other day. Remember, we were
watching. Oh, no, not those are the little stink bugs.
Yeah, but still. But
these are, I think they're called leaf-footed bugs. Oh, they are. Yeah, the big flying at your head ones. Yeah. Fixing to put my little tomato plants into big pots. Our tomatoes are kind of struggling this year. I don't know. My seedlings aren't doing, the tomato seedlings aren't doing that great, but I kind of screwed up the, I should have opened up the greenhouse the other day and I didn't, and it got a little warm in there. So I may have screwed them up. Dilute some peppermint Castile soap and the mice will eat the bugs. Ha! Maybe. My luck, they'd eat my plant. Messed up coyote. We do have,
oh, that's so gross.
Yeah, we do have coyotes, but we also have a bobcat, several bobcats in the area. So, I use the lavender Castile soap because that's the only one I buy is the Dr. See, Bronner's
I really
lavender.
I don't like Castile soap. It dries out my skin and makes it burn.
That's because you've got sensitive, like, pasty skin. Mine used to be that way until I started going outside every day. I got tanner. But then I get stupid tan lines where my sunglasses are.
Okay, but
my
you
hairline.
Actually tan. I
no, I burn first. You don't remember the Neapolitan? Where my legs were three different colors?
Oh, I'm in the way.
Protein pioneer.
I don't know why it does this every once in a while.
That's weird.
I don't have pasty skin and I do the same.
See? Yeah.
I know. Maybe that's what it is.
My arms have gotten better though. They still need a.
They're a little darker.
No, I meant like the bumps and stuff on my arm.
That orange stuff is killing me.
Look. I scrubbed it so hard like I did this and it just burned, so I'm not doing it again tonight.
I think everyone has to get a base burn first each summer. Yeah, pretty much. Oh, Christy, that's bad.
Kristen Hansen, good to see you.
Abby, sounds like you need
Tega Alexander.
Cetaphil. It is one of those. That's the lotion I have. It's for my face, but they have a rough and bumpy skin. It's a salicylic acid lotion.
Yes, I just use a regular lotion.
And I also have the cleanser.
But see, the Castile soap does dry out my skin some, but I also use lotion after my shower, so it's not near as bad.
Have a good night.
Really tan.
Yeah.
Hey.
I'm darker than your Trumpified arm.
Trumpified. Dang.
She's orange.
Look, I'm going to try it again one day, but I'm going to do it lighter. And I'm going to
do it right there.
I'm going to follow the instructions.
I don't know why he's on the fly.
Otasia. I like it. My parents were hippies. I know a girl named Sasha. It's like Sasha, but there's an I in there. So it's Sasha.
See, I don't know why, but the names aren't showing up colored anymore.
Huh.
But like North Shore isn't
strange.
Yeah, I don't know.
So
North Shore preparedness.
And I still have the showers.
Thanks for coming in. Good to see you.
Always good to see you, Sean.
I was bragging on Sean yesterday at my mama's.
Sorry.
I gave my mama his channel link for the oven canning stuff because she told me that you can't put jars in the oven. I said, well, Sean's been doing it for a long time. I've done it several times and never had a problem. No, you're not going to put them in the oven at 400 degrees. You know? Is that tan why Abby is drawn to high school? Oh, man.
We need to go ahead and wrap up. But if you guys have any prayer requests, we'd be happy to write those down and pray for you. Bub says he's getting ready to get off of YouTube.
Yeah, I don't know why, but like none of my names show up in colors on here. Either that or it's all everybody's green, like highlighted green. It's weird. Oh, I don't know. It's weird. Giant insect movies were a thing when I was a kid. Oh, yeah. They had like ants.
Oh, yeah. And arachnophobia. And Starship Troopers was like a giant insect as an alien, I believe.
A Bug's Life is literally just about bugs.
Oh, court for house insurance today.
Which one?
A Bug's Life.
For Laura. No. Oh, for Hurricane Laura. Oh, so you're this area.
Oh, yeah. We were directly hit by Hurricane Laura.
They said they're going to court for house insurance today.
Oh,
Hurricane Laura.
Definitely. Or they went.
Yeah.
Prayers for our country, prayers for the Ukrainian and Russian people, all of the people affected by the crisis. Prayers for God to move in a great way in our world.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
Christy, what part of Tennessee are you moving to? Set up camping shower outside after Hurricane Ida. Might be using that for cooling off. Yeah.
Is yours touched?
Mine is not touched.
Pending mediation.
There's a mouse right there.
Okay. Sean has a request. I must have missed it.
More tests on Tuesday.
Okay. Got it.
Prayers for Sean for North Shore preparedness's health. For certain.
Keep us posted on that, Sean. Uh, Pray for rain, not snow. Yeah, we're in a drought here as well.
You can have your seat back.
YouTube has done things. Oh. I'm not eligible for monetization. They blocked some of my videos, and there's no reason why. Wow.
Hmm. Well, if you move to another platform like Rumble, we do have a channel on Rumble. Look us up. We'd be happy to follow you there.
Southwest Tennessee, about 20 minutes from Andy and C. Oh, well, that's cool, Christy. Cool.
Yeah.
I know our daughter Katie is in the Nashville area. It's suburbs of Nashville.
Yes, we are on Rumble. Broussard Homestead, no space. Rumble is sort of our backup platform right now. We've ported a lot of our videos over there. I need to update that and move more videos there too.
How much, if any, do you make on Rumble?
I think we've made 1 cent. I'm not sure how the monetization and stuff goes. I'm not as familiar with Rumble as I am with YouTube, honestly. At this point, like I said, it's just a kind of a backup plan, Plan B. So I haven't really explored.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah, appreciate that. Mind and Body Co. just posted our Rumble link. Thank you for that.
Henry's taking up Kate's slack because you know.
And doing a great job of it. Thank you, Henry.
Her computer died.
Rumble isn't user friendly, but they don't censor. Oh, yeah,
right.
I agree with that. And you pay for live streaming on Rumble, I believe. So I haven't bothered trying to live stream there.
All right. That's it, right? All right, guys, I think that's about it. I think I have all the prayer requests, but I'm going to go back through the chat before I close it up for the night and make sure that I've gotten everything.
I hope you enjoyed tonight's chat as much as we did.
If you have any more prayer requests, please feel free to leave them in the chat. Even after we turn the live off, I'm going to leave it open for a while so I can review the chat and make sure I get everything.
Keep an eye out for more videos coming from us. We got inspired and lots of ideas tonight.
Yeah.
So we will be live again next Thursday night. So until then.
If not sooner.
If not sooner, because I am on vacation right now. So until we see you again, good night and God bless.
See you next week, guys.